to you something. By the way, how many people don't understand my English? Yeah, not a problem at all, huh? Okay. Those who don't speak English shouldn't learn it from me. Because I hardly speak the language. In fact, I managed just to memorize a lot of text. Anyway, in the last few days, ahead of this wonderful gathering, like Ken Jebsen and others, I've been subject to an insane defamation campaign. None of it was substantiated. It was followed by fabricated quotes. I was called a Holocaust denier and a Holocaust relativist. Yet, not one genuine reference was made to my own writings or my talks. In my work, I criticize instead the Holocaust being reduced into a crude religion, an intolerant dogma. In my writing, I protest against all history laws, the Nakba laws in Israel. You're not allowed to talk about the Palestinian ethnic cleansing, Armenian genocide. And I'm also not happy with Holocaust denial laws. And why? Because history, for me, is the attempt to narrate the past as we are moving along. As such, it must be sustained as a dynamic discourse, subject to constant change and revision. Even if these changes are very problematic and make us feel very uncomfortable. For me, history is an ethical message. And why? Only when we revise the past, we may be able once again to rethink our future and destiny and make it look better. In recent days, some German press referred to me as an anti-Semite. Am I really? Have I ever criticized anyone, including Jews, as a people, as a race, as a biology, as an ethnicity? Never. My work is anti-racist. I've dedicated my entire adult life to fighting racism through my music, through my writing, and through my performances. Thank you. I'm opposing all forms of biologically oriented politics. White, black, gender, as well as Jewish. Many of you are Marxists. You remember what Marxism was all about. It was there to unite us. By now, we are educated to think as a, to speak as a Jew, as a black, as a woman, as a feminist, as a gay. This is divide and conquer.
Searching for that which brings humans together. This is also including Jews, by the way. In my writings and talks, I make clear distinction between the Jews, the people, which I never criticize, never. Judaism, the religion, which I rarely deal with, and Jewishness, the politics, the ideology, the culture. In my work, I'm focusing on the latter. The ideology, the politics, the culture. I do believe that ideology, politics, and culture of all people, must be subject to criticism. But if you want to talk about Holocaust denial, I'll tell you something about denial. To deny intellectuals, authors, and artists the right to express their views in the open is where fascism starts. And this is a direct message to Mr. Grossman, who spoke here before the talk, because he wasn't happy with artists talking. What I saw in Germany in the last few days suggests to me that some segments within your society really learned nothing from the history of your country. To deny the Holocaust is to deny its meaning, to turn your eyes away when you see evil, like in Palestine, and in Syria, and in Libya, and in Iraq. To let your heart become cold when you yourself participate in evil or celebrate hatred. To deny the Holocaust is to skip your own inability to tolerate others and otherness. This is again a message to Mr. Grossman. Why are you so afraid of me? Debate me. It is beyond painful for me to witness Germany being blindly led into the same trap just 7 decades after the liberation of Auschwitz. But I would like to add one more line on Palestine. Some Germans claim to be tormented by the past, by the atrocities of the Third Reich. If this is indeed the case, let me please remind you a simple, embarrassing fact. The Palestinians are the last victims of Hitler. And it is 70 years if you start in 48, and it is 100 years if you start in 1917. Enough. It was the extent of the Shoah that brought support to Zionism and led to the formation of the Jewish state in Palestine. But it is the innocent Palestinians who for the last 7 decades have been paying the price for crimes committed by Europeans. If you feel guilty about Hitler, stand for Palestine and the Palestinians. Thank you.
Thank you.